welcome back to the Baden Masters, the first event of the season of the Curling Champions Tour. My name is Roger Gulka, and I have the pleasure to be here with Kirk Myers. We'll be commenting this game today, so this final.
Well, thanks for having me. It's pretty neat to be able to do this in the Champions Tour. This is the first event we played in, and I hope to be back, come overseas again one of these years.
Yeah. So you were playing third with the Canadian team there, Laycock, right?
That's right. Yeah, I play third for Steve Laycock team, and we just missed the playoffs, so now I'm chatting with you here.
Well, at least there's a good point to losing.
Yeah, this is a lot better on this side of the glass, isn't it?
At least you're not going to lose.
Yeah. Hope not. You guys will fire me after a couple ends maybe, though.
No, I think I'll be fine. Yeah. So actually, quite a nice game there for us. I mean, two really, really impressive teams, actually, we've seen. Very regular. They've played really well. I think they haven't lost a game yet. And one of them will lose now, so, and the other one will be the champion.
Yep. We got, I guess, the reigning world champs and the reigning bronze medalist at the Worlds. Cruz is the bronze medalist, and Wilsrud is the world champ. So, yes. Can't get much better curling than that.
Oh, indeed. And
looks like they're getting right into it here in this first end.
Yeah, already two rocks put in play by Valentin Tanner. Playing lead for the Swiss team from Geneva. Playing against the Norwegians of Thomas Ulstrud.
Seems when we were playing that ice really, really swung in the first end, and you can make a lot of shots early on in the game, so looks like they're going to go right after it out of the gates here.
Yeah, well, I know we have both teams that are that like to, you can say, to play some good offensive games, so I think it will be probably a nice show, and hope that the game will stay nice and tight, actually.
And I guess you got a little experience with the Swiss team there, Roger, don't you?
Yes, I think that you have some experience with us too.
No? Well, yeah, I've you guys took it to us pretty good back in the junior days. We used to call Benoit Jesus because he never missed.
Yeah, well, Benoit is actually a very solid fourth player. It used to be maybe now it's 4 or 5 years ago, Peter De Cruz, who was skipping the team, was actually playing fourth, and finally. Coach decided at the time to switch actually Benoit for Peter, and it worked out really well, and it never changed after.
Yeah, I don't think they look back, and I think the De Cruz will be in the top 10 in the world probably after this weekend. So, boy, they make a lot of shots out there.
Yeah. De Cruz actually really fancying the third position, being very comfortable. I was talking with him about it, and
oh, that's a pistol.
Really nice slowy takeout.
I just playing beside Wilsrud all week, and they sure didn't seem like they missed much at all. Not skipping a beat from, I guess, the World Championship last year. Coming into this season, I don't know how many points they gave up, but it can't be too many.
Now a tricky shot for Claudia Petz. Just to go around a guard.
Looking pretty good. That's a pistol.
Good shot from Claudia Petz, who's been very solid all this weekend. He's actually the new player of the team. Last year, playing second was Dominic Merkey, who now, actually, for professional reasons, is not going to play this season. And he's been replaced by Claudio Petz, who was playing third with the Swiss Olympic team of Sven Michel.
Yeah, that's a nice addition to the team. Is it going to over?
Well, they took him as an alternate at the World Championships in Beijing. This year, actually. And it worked out really well, and they had a good atmosphere in the team with him. That's why they partly decided to take him
okay.
with them. and Claudio was quite happy to join, I think, and so far the team spirit seems to be quite good.
They haven't lost a game yet, so I guess it can't be so bad,
no.
Eh?
No, I don't. I guess so. So now, just open hit and roll, Peter DeCruz, try and take some position behind the guard.
Skips and plays throws third stones. Oh, just overcurled a bit on him there, but.
Yeah, I could hear Peter there. I'm disappointed, maybe a tiny bit of sweeping.
It's kind of interesting. Those hit and rolls are probably one of the toughest shots in the game, but everyone seems like they expect to make them all the time, but I bet you it's about a 30% shot in reality, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it really depends on the speed you throw, because it will, and the angle. I mean, both things are actually really important, because, I mean, if you throw harder, you have to hit the rock more in the center. And it's very, very difficult to manage with the sweeping.
There you go. There's another example. Just probably overcurled on about an inch on about 130 feet of ice, the shot is missed, but really probably threw it pretty well.
Yeah. And despite the hard sweeping, they did manage to keep the shooter in the rings. And now Peter will go for a draw behind that center guard. He's just saying, actually, yeah, we played there already, so we know the ice. Talking about the ice. That's about what he gave to Valentin before.
Peter gets this one in a good spot. Thomas Olsrud is going to be hard-pressed here and going to have to make a run back to get out of it. But Peter might get the force out of this end yet and have a good first end.
Yeah. So, our line's good.
Looks a little light, or am I?
It gets a bit tight.
Encore.
We're saying it curled a lot on that side. A bit light and slow.
Yeah, that first end pebble that really seems to be cutting out there. All in all, probably not a bad result, though, depending on what Thomas does here.
Yeah, well, he might be tempted to open. He has the last draw, because it's still the first end of that final.
You know, I can tell you the boys from Saskatchewan would be ripping those guards real quick here, but can't tell the world champ what to do.
No. Well, I think he prefers the offensive game. He thought about it for sure, and he has the third Torger Nergard, who is totally capable of making those double peels. But I think that he wants to score. Maybe try and get it too with the hammer in the first end.
Yeah, I heard this morning Jerry Gertz was sending in results. I'd like to know what the winning percentages are if a team scores two or more in the first inning. That number is pretty high.
Yeah, well, after, especially with the ice conditions, the ice is really good. It's much easier to play defensive than it's quite a battle for the team that's two down to come back.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
So what they don't want there is to be behind the T-line. It will just be, I think, a little bit far.
A little bit far, but Benoit's got a chance to get out of here yet, I think.
Well, that's a key shot already right in the first end.
And with those overlap guards, if Benoit gets a good one on here, that might be the end of the end.
Well, even if he just freezes and doesn't take the shot, it will be really difficult for Thomas to score two. He can, for example, curl enough, tap it back, I don't know, 20 centimeters and lay shot in front, then he would actually even have a really good chance to steal.
Yep.
Thanks, Chief.
Oh.
He said,
"Whoa!" Sweepers look pretty happy out of the gates here.
Thanks,
Steve.
Attention.
Sweepers are quite happy.
Salmon vitesse. Whoa, pas plus. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Easy.
Sweepers
easy.
Are quite happy with it.
No bounce.
Very important now.
I think they can sweep for a little bit for line here. Maybe just Oh, yeah.
That's pretty good.
Nice shot.
Well done, Benoit.
Yeah, and it's a must make, too. He drops that one halfway, and all of a sudden, Thomas Holzer is looking at getting three. Makes that really good now, and probably forced to one. So that was a must make from Benoit here in the first end.
That's a Torger's rock that ended up just a little bit too far. Now he will need to bite the button to score.
Track him.
He's going to try to drop this one about top eight. Was that right, Roger? Did I see that right? And maybe give himself an angle on his last one for a blank or maybe 2 points, depending on where it sits.
Yeah, I think that you're right in that he what he really wants is actually to get one of his yellows in front of that red. He might potentially be able to use.
Nice.
And it's not over yet. 3 rocks remain to be played. And the Norwegian team has the last rock because they had a better last stone draw than De Cruz's team. It was funny because Benoit told me that before he was going to throw his last stone draw, Ulstrud told him, if you don't have a zero, you're not
going to
toss. And Benoit threw it maybe 10 centimeters from the pin. Made a zero.
Oh man, I don't doubt that. I watched those guys play this weekend. Oh my goodness, they don't miss. That's funny. I got a few stories about that. Those kind of words back home too. That's what makes the game fun, hey?
Come up, Milan.
Well, it was a good advice from Thomas.
Huh?
And that's a pretty solid draw there. The angles are really good for the Norwegians.
Ah, Pila, okay.
You know, I'd be almost tempted to, this might be crazy, but play the same shot and you might get and come onto your red one and just move them because with this angle that Ulsrud has made for himself, he probably only scores one if he makes an absolute pistol. And if you would end up putting a guard. See if I can figure out this telestrator here, Roger.
Okay.
You would end up putting a guard right there.
Moi, je pense qu'avec ça, il vient genre normal, peut-être qu'il reste.
This area, yeah. Sorry, but that's the best I can do for now, folks. You might create an angle that might be better for the Norwegians to make it easier to score. So if you come in on the other side, you may have a chance.
Moi, je pense là, c'est bien, juste là.
If you can come in through the other side this way, I think that's what you're thinking, like this.
Yeah, that's just it. And the reason I'm thinking that is I don't know if it changes much, but that might actually give him a chance to steal a point if he just end up moving that red one about 6 inches. Whereas this way, he may be just making the angle better. But that being said, I'm sitting behind the glass and those guys are playing, so maybe I should keep my mouth shut too. So
it seems like they've opted for the guard.
Okay, ligne bien. Ligne oui. 3. Lynn, c'est bon.
2.
Oh, rien maintenant, rien maintenant.
Plutôt 3.
Oh, balle, faudra finir. Attends. Attends. Juste là.
Ouais, looks like he's got another made shot here.
Yep.
It's gonna curl enough for him.
Okay, man. Come on, man.
Oh, that's actually, that's a nice shot if they got a biter out of that. Well done.
Okay.
Has he got room to bite the side of the pin there for two, Roger? I guess he would, eh?
Well, he has the space. I mean, yeah, he has it.
Yeah, you just got to run it down the ice and drop it on the exact spot, eh?
Well, they have to be careful because there's a big swing at the end. They don't want to touch the red.
Isn't that the truth? You catch some of that fresh pebble and boy, oh boy, she might overcurl on you.
Makeable shot for Thomas Ulstrud is there. And he's asking a tiny bit more ice.
Would it be fair to say this is his comfort zone? Yeah. Draws over hits?
Yeah. Well, I don't think he probably wants to take too many risks in the first.
Oh, I agree.
worst comes to worst, he just takes his one and forces the Swiss team to one in the second and try again in the third, score two.
And at the end of the day, hanging a point on the board is never a bad thing.
All the sweepers don't seem so happy with it. That's not going to be even really close.
Right weight, I think he might have had it. Hey, the line would have come in there a little nicer.
Yeah, the line seemed to be quite well. So, there we go. That's going to be a one for Norway. So, I think the Swiss are going to be quite happy. They've managed to force the Norwegians to one, which is a peculiarity of curling, is that you like when your opponent scores ones. You want to score more than one when you have the last rock.
Yep. The crews will be satisfied with that result, and some good shots by Benoit to set that up.
Might get a little strike. Yeah. The ice, I think. Good shots.
So we had some statistics there who came up. And if Ulstrud scores a two in the first end, out of 45 games, they won 37 and lost 8.
So about, I'm just trying to decipher that. It looks like if you score two or more in the first end, you're probably going to win about 75 to 80, well, about 84.5% of your games, if I'm reading Jerry's stuff right there. So, after the first end, you're going to give yourself an 85% chance to win.
Okay, 2-3. Easy.
2-3.
Just that.
Yeah, but if you score...
Easy.
If you score one in the first end, that's so amazing statistics. Out of 4,704 games, you win 2,637 times, so that's 56% probability of winning. So anyway, Peter managed to force Ulstrud to one, so he, in theory, has a 44% chance.
It's kind of interesting, actually, when you make you think about that. That's a neat number. But I guess without hammer, too, if we had that score, who had hammer in the first end, would probably be a pretty significant advantage, too, for Ulstrud.
Well, it's always your guarantee against a bad first end.
Yeah.
It's always that possibility of taking that commanding 2-point lead.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Jerry must not sleep. I mean, what time was he up this morning if he was feeding results from Toronto? It would have been probably about 3 or 4 in the morning, I would think.
Okay, whoa, plus.
Thanks,
plus.
Ben. Attention.
Ligne, c'est bon, attention!
Oh.
Prise! Ligne parfaite! C'est encore
Benoît,
un peu
large. Benoît!
Encore un peu large.
Yeah, they.
Ok,
bien match.
What we noticed was.
Sliding.
We're going into the second, third end, and I just heard someone say there it's sliding, I think. I don't know the languages, but I heard that anyways. But yeah, we noticed in the second or third end, boy, that ice sure got quick and keen. Armin does a damn good job here with the ice. Some of the best ice we played on, for sure. All I can remember is when we played you guys in juniors that whenever we play Peter and Benoit now, we don't leave Peter a draw to the button to beat us because he'll put his sweepers on it all the way down, Roger, and beat us to go to the World Final.
Ah, good times.
Yeah, maybe for you.
Yeah, it was. At least an interesting outcome. Okay, Lin, pas mal, 4,
plutôt 4. Lin, oui. Okay, whoa.
So the Norwegian strategy is to keep the game in the middle now that they don't have the last rock. Try and reduce that scoring zone by placing some rocks around the forefoot.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and it just rubs off.
Yeah, they were pretty satisfied with that most of the way down, and she must have just broke out of there, eh? And maybe a hair light, but
could
have been a pick also.
Yeah, for sure.
We've seen that already this weekend.
Yeah, it's an unfun part of the game, but I guess it's part of the game, those picks, eh?
Well, I think you can do all what you want. It's something you never manage to 100% eliminate 100%. So, I mean, you just have to deal with it. It's those uncontrollable elements of the game. So, in a way, there's no point in getting angry because you just can't do anything about it.
Yep.
That's life.
Yep, that's right. You do all you can to control everything you can, and the rest you got to let be as it may.
Vanlig opp. Oh, rent. Rent, ligger bra. Yep. Hardt. Hardt. Hardt.
Oh, yeah. Bozard's controlling that control zone right in the front of the house there without Hammer on the center line. And Peter's not liking that too much. Looks like he's going to get rid of that.
There's starting to be a bit too many yellow rocks in front of that T line. And that red rock, which isn't shot, it's really not helping him. Which is shot, sorry.
And actually, if Claudio was able to make this shot with that corner guard out there yet, I'd be very satisfied if that was Peter, the way things would be shaping up.
Just a bit wide.
Okay.
Yeah, just didn't quite get enough curl on that that one there. Looks like a lot of yellow in there, but probably not hating it if I'm Peter yet. That's for sure. It's early enough in the end with the good hitting team that these guys are. They might get a chance to use that corner guard or split the house for a deuce yet here.
Well, basically, they can keep that red rock in play and use it as some backing. No need really to get rid of it. Just tap it back.
How's your Norwegian?
Oh, I know.
You understand what they're saying?
Not really. I just understand the word bra, which means good.
Okay.
If you're bra, it means it's good.
These guys had a lot of bra this week.
Yeah. So linje bra, I suppose it means line's good.
Hold on. Rein. Nære. Yep. Oh. Hard. 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 Whoa. Hard. Whoa. Rein. Rein. Whoa. 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 Whoa.
Whoa! Nice shot.
That's pretty good.
Might have just over curled a hair on him, hey?
Well, I think that Peter has to remove that yellow rock at the top of the rings. That one's probably their most dangerous rock in play.
I agree. Peter can make a nice one here and even just roll that top one over the other side there.
Probably the best shot would be to remove that yellow one roll there where he's just showing. And maybe if you can, you can sort of clip a bit off on those two yellows.
Yeah, even if you get rid of two of those stones, you're sitting pretty good.
So, well, Peter was just saying the most important is actually to roll. After what happens behind is not that important. I think they absolutely have to hit. And Peter following his instinct.
Doesn't look like he's going to put a fire it, or is he going to throw it hard?
Yeah, he's saying, I'd like to bring the game a bit to the side.
That's a good plan.
So they're going to play what they call a normal weight, so that's about 10.5 seconds from hog to hog, so not particularly fast takeout, just fast enough to remove one or two rocks out of play. The line's very important for them. have to keep their shooter.
That's too bad.
A little
straighter there than they're anticipating, I think, a little bit. They know Tanner on that, Claudio on that side, hang one a little straight too.
But it's tough really get that, like we were talking about, the difficulty of the hit and roll.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, I mean, in the end, he didn't have to roll particularly behind the guard, but I think that it was quite important for him to keep his shooter.
Yeah, I agree, Roger. This might be one of those ends now. He might get forced.
Looks like it so far. I haven't seen the call, but it seems like a hack weight to get rid of this red.
Probably play the double on those top ones and see if Benoit can make a couple doubles.
Nose hit.
Hit from Peter here to maybe save the end yet. Gonna need a little help. Nero's routine for that to happen.
Yeah, some new stats just came up. So when Peter actually gives up points without the hammer in the first end, when he gives up a one, who already has a record of 15 wins and 16 losses, so about 50-50.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it more or less corresponds to the previous statistics, about a 56% win if when you score in the first end one.
Yep. Interesting. Patented shake by Mr. Olsrud there as he does his pre-shot ritual.
I need a bit more on the stats there. When Olsrud scores one in the first end, he wins 43 times out of 59.
Oh.
That's about a three-quarter record.
And that's just one point, one or more?
Single score.
Oh, single score. Okay. Oh, yeah, I see. Looks like, Benoit, if he makes a pistol with his hit and roll, like we talked about how tough that is, but he might actually get that double in the back, roll behind the corner, and he might get a couple points out of this yet. Got to make a pistol, but it's certainly possible.
I can do the double and roll, so.
Peter's going really good.
Yeah, Peter's saying just focus on the hit and roll. If you get the double, that's just good, but just focus on the hit and roll. We want to try and be there. That's the most important.
I think I agree with him there. It's if you happen to snag that double on the way by, you might keep the blank alive. But if he makes his hit and roll good, boy, I think Olsrud's in a little bit of trouble. He'll have to make a freeze around a new spot on the ice, which he'll probably make because he doesn't seem to miss much. But
Alstrom seems quite confident.
This. Wait!
A little over curl there from Benoit.
So Wilstrud probably going to be quite happy. Things are going as planned. He will have a shot to force Benoit to score one. And if he hits on the nose, well, I think Benoit will just have to hit throw exactly the same rock than before and get his one.
Yep. I think Wolfsrud's playing a little bit of a more relaxed schedule this season is what we were talking with the boys last night. They felt a little burnt out over the last few years, and they said they want to get to the point where every time they go curling now, it's exciting for them. And I think lots of curlers can relate when you do play lots, and you're always on the road traveling, and that you can get a little bit of a burnout. And I think they're playing maybe three or four Bondsfields before the Europeans and Worlds, so a lot more relaxed. Charge the batteries.
I mean, that team was preparing so hard for the Olympics last year. I mean, and now the next Olympics are in 4 years, so you see that quite often. The team's kind of taking a bit of a break, and then the two seasons before the Olympics really going with putting a booster on it.
Yep, for sure, Roger.
I can't understand them, actually. You know, sometimes when you play so much at the end of the season, you're actually quite happy it's over and you can start thinking about something else.
Yeah, yeah. And the thing about what we do is, as amateur athletes, is Monday morning after it's all over, we have to go back to work. So it can get tiring after doing that for 15, 16 weekends in the winter. But labor of love, and if we didn't love what we do, we wouldn't be doing it. Because looks like he's right on target here, and be tied up after the. Oh, did I talk too soon? Nope.
Oh, it's fine. No, I'm a bit happy.
I guess it's 1-1 score with Wolfsrud Hammer going into the third end. Well curled game so far. There's Mr. Galka on the screen.
Oh, hello. Wait. That's us in the comments.
They put us up in the nice big booth up here.
Yeah. Yeah, we look very serious with our headphones and stuff.
We're kind of a big deal, aren't we?
Yeah. It's very important.
This is where the big bucks are made, up in the booth.
Yeah. So are you hoping on to have a career at CBC or something?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if I won't be able to take Mike Harris or Russ Howard's job for a while. Maybe after I win an Olympic medal, they'll consider me.
Yeah, maybe.
Going into the third end here, the final of the Baden Masters on the Curling Champions Tour. Both these teams haven't lost a game yet this weekend, and they're both playing real well, so we'll have to see what shakes out as a champion. Would it be fair to say that the only two teams that haven't lost yet, Roger? Or would they have been the only teams that went undefeated in the round robin?
Yes.
They were the best teams all week, and on good ice, playing against some of the best teams in the world, that's usually how it shakes out. Looks like they're getting into it again this end. Nice tight guard by Mr. Tanner there.
Veldig bra linje. Hvor lang vi? Tight som noe.
Nei, fart er grei.
Bra linje. Plass.
Det er nærhet av tightet. Vi er mye.
Plass.
Kjempevide. Det
går. Så, ja.
Ja, hard.
Kom igjen. Bra, Vaj. Lite finnestånd her, altså.
Kom igjen, kom igjen, eller?
Bra spill.
Get snack.
to get one of the top eight here and again get control of that control zone we always talk about. Mr. Tanner can put this one in a good spot. They'll be sitting well. Ah, they got a little pick there, I think.
You're saying it's better if it doesn't go across the hog line. It will. Well, interesting now. Two guards, two center guards, more or less.
Han får skråfris her, halv åtte, så vi drar full åtte her.
Looks like they're, Wilson's just going to go for the junior deuce here at the start anyways, and just get one to the wing. Fly two, put some heat on De Cruz here early.
Ja, gjerne kølle litt også. Kølle litt, bare...
Those picks are... Not fun to deal with, but these guys look like they can handle it pretty well. They didn't flinch on that one, so.
Oh.
Little stiff.
So now Claudio Petz having the chance to get a good one in the forefoot behind those guards.
Okay, flat.
Try to take advantage in the end. Call in a T-line. Saying it's more than T-line.
Rocks seem to be gliding again.
Yeah. You're satisfied with the line, but not that much with the weight. Just a little bit too far, and that gives that possibility for Olsrud to ask Christopher Sva to play a freeze or just a draw on top of the forefoot. Use that red rock as a backing. And by definition, rocks behind the T line are always a disadvantage.
Well, they got the pick too.
It's starting again.
Looks like they've must be a little spot in the ice there, something that wasn't cleaned up because it looked like it picked about the same spot. It's De Cruz's second rock at the end.
Yeah, De Cruz showing more or less where he wants the rock. So not necessarily shot rock, just covering the forefoot inside the house behind its guard. 8 foot circle would be good, I think.
I think that would put it in a pretty good spot. It probably sinks into the forefoot. Top of the four would be all right, but you don't want to risk being heavy again, I don't think. Nice shot.
Yeah, that's good.
Put a little pressure on Olsrud here to make something happen.
Both teams have been a bit unlucky there with those picks, but now it's the Swiss team who's in a better position so far. We see that sometimes it can change very, very fast, so let's wait and see.
Looks like he's playing a little tap back.
Yeah, probably backline weight is asked.
That's, I guess, what you say, bra.
Bra, yeah, it's pretty bra.
Så
Cruz will try to roll that back now. I think
I think Peter has to hit.
Again, that's one of those things I remember we always say it too. We don't want to leave him that hit and roll. But if you're going to leave him any shot on the ice, like we talked about, that's probably the best one to leave him. Close. Just overrolled it.
Aye.
Is that what he said?
More or less. That's what his face said. Now we're back in the situation of Christopher Sva, where he had to play that freeze.
Are they playing the tap out there, Roger?
More like they're playing a tap.
I guess to lie two, maybe, and bring that top 8-1 into play. See the expression on his face there.
Yeah, we have some greetings from Dominic Merkey, who's watching the games from the U.S. and who loves Team De Cruz. From a teammate, so big hello to Dominic Merkey.
Good to hear from you, man.
And a hello to Isabel, his dear girlfriend.
She's a lucky woman.
No kidding.
Again, I don't know if Dominic Merkey was the second for De Cruz team the last couple seasons, and now he took off and started new chapters like we talked about earlier. Sit down. No. Can't handle it, Peter. The boys have to sweep harder.
Yeah, ask Valentin and Claudia to go to the gym a bit.
That needs to one hand to pull akkurat midt på åttefoten. Perfekt å være den som biter firefot, ikke noe mer. Kjøler opp. Ja, jeg tror det. Fin brekk på slutten her.
Thomas Solstrid still very calm. Torgo Nergut throws a draw.
Get a top 8 probably, maybe bite the forefoot and get around that guard.
Svav hvis du må gå! Bare bite fire! Bite fire!
Den er løs!
Hardt! Linje gull! Linje gull! Curle! Curle!
Everyone looks pretty satisfied if you get some curl here.
Yep.
You know, it looks like the Benoit will be able to maybe get a roll under there. A little tight to the guard, but I think it's worth the risk.
Okay, now mindre curl.
Peter's asking for a nose hit.
Attention.
shot if he can get to the nose.
Come here. Ooh,
just made it.
Yeah, that's a party. Is it short of them?
Rolls just a little bit on the wrong side.
Hackies?
I think the thinking was if you could get to the nose of that rock, Wilser would have no option but to roll out about a foot or two and might set up a double there on those top two. But it looks like Wilser could probably get under now. And I really don't know where Peter's going to go or Benoit's going to go. I guess around it all maybe, hey?
Yeah, well, I think there will just be the draw option.
But,
if... The problem, though, is that Thomas has to make sure that he gets some roll. If he hits right on the nose, there will be a double. That will not be that difficult, actually, to play. And then the Swiss could be lying four for Thomas's last rock. So he has to roll on the inside, if possible, to get hidden. As the curl.
Picked or not? Out of the water shot.
Good. Bit of stress there, I think.
Oh, here it is coming in. Nice finish on that stone.
Yeah, big, big swing at the end. It could have picked, actually.
Might have. Not a whole bunch of weight on the stone. What a shot. That's
but the result is good.
Play the run back, it looks like.
Oh, I think it...
Okay. Is it there?
One...
I guess they could, hey? I'm glad he's throwing it, not me, I'll tell you that
one. Well, if he does it perfectly, I mean, he can do a run back double.
Yeah, just lie four.
Lie four, hidden, of course.
Shots are easy from up here, I guess.
Well, yeah, it's easy. You just have to hit that guard in the right spot there, and it's fine.
Yep.
Draw.
Just throw the right weight at the broom, and you'll be fine.
Yeah, that's about it.
Easy
whoa,
game.
Whoa.
I think he's a bit
no,
wide.
No.
Whoa. It's good.
Oh, just over curl the hair, I guess, huh?
Sadly there, I think he just didn't push that yellow far enough to... have it lie second shot. I think it's still lying first. Anyway, there's first, second, third, whatever shot. I mean, Ulstrud's play is a draw. No other option now. So I think it's going to be a draw for two. You don't seem particularly certain on who's shot. So
well, up here it looks like it's looks yellow, like doesn't it?
I think it's yellow.
Yeah, I think pretty comfortably.
Are you sure? Are you sure? There's a lot of slipper. There's a lot of slipper. Se opp da! Som var nærmest i så fall! T-line! T-line!
T-line som gjelder!
T-line!
This one's successful. That takes a huge jump in the game.
Ikke rør!
Oh lord.
They're right off it here. Did they get caught in that quick path? Or?
Oh, it just
nice shot.
Stops at the end. And Thomas seemed a bit worried at some point.
Oh, whenever sweepers mess up a sweep, the skipper sure tells him, eh?
Yeah. Those rocks are, we can say, quite simple, but they're so important. I mean, that extra point really makes a difference Well, you put a 2 instead of a 1 when you have the last rock, it really changes everything. And now they're taking a 2-point lead coming in the fourth, starting the fourth. And, I mean, they're in a commanding situation in the game there. Now they took a good advantage of their hammer.
Yep. Yeah, that slides another foot and a half, and De Cruz gets exactly what he wants. He forces them to 1, gets the hammer back, and the fact that it didn't slide that far, he takes 2 points and 3-1. To be honest, I don't think Ozer loses this game too much, but that's why we play the game, and that's why anything can happen on ice. But that's a commanding lead to start the game.
Well, the good news for Peter is that there are still 5 ends to be played.
That's right.
So he has 5 ends to catch up. Well, in theory, what you do is that you take 2, leave 1, take 2.
Yeah, if everything works out perfectly, it's
you win.
That would be the way to do it.
Or maybe he's just going to play the strategy to score 5.
Yeah, that would work too. And these guys make enough shots, they could get there. Their Ozerud strategy will change a little bit here. They'll be going a little bit more on the defensive, I guess you could say, and they drop their first one in the rings.
So now we see a different opening. Rock in the house and corner guard. Now Thomas Ulstrud will not try to score. I think he'll just try and force Team De Cruz to 1. Keep a 1-point lead with the hammer.
Yep, I think if Ulstrud would be successful in forcing him to 1 again, that would be another major victory in N4 here.
Yeah, because he would be 1 up with the last strike in the fifth. If he scores a 1 or 2, then, I mean, he keeps his lead. Even if he just scores a 1 in the 5, he could actually even blank the 5 and take 1 or 2 in the sixth.
Mm-hmm. It seems the first 4 or 5 ends of any game is just try to work your way into control or get the hammer back in 6-7-8, and then you can really go to work and make sure you control the rest of the game and end with a W. And Ozer's doing a good job of that so far.
Well, if you can assure yourself a tie with Lastrock in the 8th, I mean, that's generally a
pretty nice feeling.
A good situation. Maybe we can ask him if there are statistics about how many times do the team that's tied with Lastrock wins the game.
I would take a rough guess, about 98%, 95%, something in there.
Say maybe 75-80.
Really?
Maybe.
No, you might be right. No, that's true. Just going off the numbers we were working with. Yeah, you're right. I think it is 80%.
I don't know. I'm just guessing. Anyway, a high percentage. I mean, they were talking about maybe putting some different rules, maybe adding a 5 rock free guard zone.
Yeah, we got the opportunity to play that a couple of Grand Slams last season over in Canada there, and it was actually quite fun. And what it did was the game never seemed to be over. You always have to keep pressing, even if you're up 3 going into the 6th, 7th end. It seems that to get out of the end, you aren't making a double peel anymore. You're making a draw to the corner or draw a freeze to get out of an end. And it's always, you just kind of keep pumping away, and a little more exciting, I guess, to watch. If you're a diehard curling fan, that's for sure.
Yeah, well, it really will change completely the strategy and the way of thinking out the ends.
Yep.
I know that the World Curling Federation is thinking about ways to make the game more attractive, for example. Or, well, already that free guard zone was added to make the game more attractive, and I think that's actually a really good rule.
Yep,
forces the teams to play.
Force them to play. I mean, I don't think, I guess we probably wouldn't remember before the free guard zone, but the stories you hear, it was a pretty boring game. You basically hit for 79 rocks and draw on the 8th, or the 80th for the win, but maybe one or two ends there with some rocks in play. But sure, this is curling when there's rocks in play, decisions to be made, and lots on the line.
Well, I mean, 1-0s. I mean, football, soccer scores are virtually impossible now with the free guard zone rule as they were existing before.
Yep.
I think the minimum I've seen was a 2-1 with the free guard zone.
Yeah, we had a few 2-1 games last year, but they sure don't happen very often, and that was a choice we made to play like that. But usually one or the other team isn't going to let you do it.
Well, at some point, I mean, even if one team wants to play only defensive, if the other team just puts two guards up front, I mean, it forces the play.
That's right. 76% of the time tied with Hammer since 2010 and 11, including looks like all the playdowns, the tours and the Olympics. 76% of the time tied with Hammer wins. So Roger was a lot more realistic than I was, I'll tell you that.
Yes.
A shot. Wow.
That's really nice.
The boys worked her in there from the hog line in and put her on the dot, but I think DeCruz could pick it out of there if he chose to, but I don't know. Got a question here from Hans with the 5-rock rule, if they're more time consuming. I'm just trying to think. I think we got a little extra time to play those games. No, I don't think we did. No, it actually flowed pretty nice because for the simple fact, I think everyone was invested, so there was less decisions to be made because everyone knew that what decisions had to be made on that in that certain situation, whereas a 4-rock rule, sometimes you get baited, well, should we play the defensive shot or the offensive shot, and you debate it. But we found that it was basically all offense. So the decisions actually were scary, but kind of knew what we had to make. So I don't, Jerry might even know if we get extra time in the 5-rock rule, but I don't think so.
Yeah, well, I think that now they are changing the rules about the clock now with the World Curling Federation just changed, actually, between playing times now to thinking time.
Yep, that's right. The World Curling Tour has been doing it for some time, but looks like the World Curling Federation might be adopting that as well. Is that right, Roger?
I think so. They were talking about it after the Olympics it's like the moment to change the rules.
Yep.
And that's quite a major change, and I think it's a really good change, actually, because it favorizes the offensive game. Because when you throw draws, I mean, the draw takes more time to cross the ice than a fast takeout. So if you play defensive, you will, by definition, be faster. So the team that plays more draws actually is disadvantaged. As with the thinking time, it will not matter anymore. It's actually the teams that think too long who will be disadvantaged.
Yep, and I agree with that. It makes the game a little more fair. Looks like we're getting quite an end here. I think I'm not sure what they're talking about, but if they can, they make that little hit and roll, Ozerud. Boy, Peter's going to be in some heat.
Yeah. Det er ikke optimalt, Torger.
Men her så dytter hun bare litt utover.
Myk hakk!
Jeg kan legge han sånn dobbelt der, så han sitter veldig fint etterpå.
Hva har du gikk i sted?
Ja.
Myk hakk der da.
Ok.
Håvard holder den.
Hack,
Chris. Hack,
Chris.
Yep.
Hack, Chris. Hard, 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 hard,
hard, hard, hard, hard, hard, hard, hard, hard, hard, hard,
the winning rate when you're when you have the last rock tied in with the last rock is at 80%, so a bit higher than in general, only in the Grand Slams, and now. He's also a confirmation that all slams will be played with a 5-rock free guard zone. So looking forward to that.
Yeah, it's exciting to play.
Yeah. See the importance of the hits and rolls. I mean, really precise shot.
Nice, sitting nice for Ulzer right now.
Hmm. Yeah, great play from Torger.
That's not looking like much fun for Peter and Benoit there.
They really need a precise freeze or something. They need what they really need now, for sure, is a rock in front of the tee line, and it has to cover somehow one of those yellows. I think a rock on the center line where they're showing right now, I think would be the best option. Of course, that's a really high precision shot. What you really want to avoid is a bump and roll into the open.
Yep, that would be almost, that could almost be a game ender, actually, if he rolls off at all. Like I say, anything can happen, but that would be a dagger. It's so weird, again, those freezes can be so tough, too. You're drawn to a dot, you throw it 6 inches heavy, and you roll off. Well, 6 inches on a sheet of curling ice is not a lot, but you got to be good on those there. Those little chap-offs are deadly.
Yeah, they really need to take position now.
Please. Okay, Vince, c'est bon. Flash, flash. Oh, easy, easy. Seulement vitesse. Vince, c'est bon. Swim.
Vince, parfait. Work on this one.
Swim. Allez, allez. Toujours, toujours. Vraiment bien, allez.
Looking pretty close. Encore. Now it has a little more legs on it.
I
think Peter knows that that might not be very good, but I guess it's still better than being a foot or two heavy, but... They're talking about maybe throwing a guard here, and Peter Benoit might have that hit and roll off that yellow one on the side, but my philosophy is generally make the easy ones and make them make the hard ones. So
the problem with that end is that now that Peter has been dragged into that little game in the center, and they haven't managed to take advantage.
Yeah, Chris Ulzrud pulled him into it a little bit there, huh? And just hasn't been able to capitalize.
Once again, you see how annoying it is to get rocks behind the tee line. You look at that red. I mean, it's close to the center, but it's more pain than anything else.
Yep, certainly is. Caused a lot of grief for him so far. Looks like Ulzrud's going to try taking away that in-off by making it. So if he would roll that, oh boy, if he'd make this one. All I can tell you is I'm glad I'm not team to cruise right now. They got Benoit and the boys have a lot of work ahead of them to send to get out of here.
Hva de satser på da? Tynn hall til tynn hall? Hall for tjukkere, bør egen.
Vi kan gå gara, altså. Den ganske lett, den der. Ja, men vi setter den veldig bra da, men da det vanskelig for folk mer enn...
Jeg liker den kålen.
Jeg liker kålen. Tynn hall.
Jo.
Expect this one to be moving. I think they're playing the in-off, is that right?
Yeah, I think they're playing the in-off. They don't want to leave it to Benoit.
Mm-hmm.
And they want to actually make it themselves first. A lot of weight.
I think this one will curl out of there if I remember this spot nicely. Oh no.
Oh,
what a shot, and the full building here in Baden was pretty happy with that. They were clapping away. That's a nice shot. It may have opened up an opportunity for Benoit here. Actually, he can probably play the freeze now to the one on the button and actually maybe top it 6 inches and get shot rock. I don't know if that's there or what, but I'm sure they'd be happy getting out of here with a point. Yeah, I guess that's no gimme.
Yeah, we had a question there from Hans who was asking if any of the CCT tournaments would be played with the 5 rock free guard zone rule, and we just got the answer from Armin Harder who said that actually no. Because teams are like playing the international competitions like the Europeans or the Worlds, and they want to stick to the WCF rules.
Yeah, I think there's definitely some good merit there, because these guys are coming here to get experience on the international stage, and you might as well follow those rules. Curling Champions Tour is doing a heck of a job in Europe here, and you can see the growth of the game. It's been pretty remarkable, and
looks like
the tour is well positioned to continue to grow, so it's good to see.
You think
he's going to play a half a rock, maybe a little double there.
The thing is that I can't see this one hidden and staying here.
No, not staying.
It's not staying, so it must touch a little bit, just a spin out. But.
Peter explaining to Thomas what he's going to do.
I think I'd play that. Hey, Roger, put a half a rock into that top yellow one. You might get everything going, all on the ones in the 4 foot going. You might have beeline two after the shot.
You need to move things around.
Yeah, for sure. I don't know if he'll move that one back of the button much, but we'll see how the drag works off of there.
The difficulty relies really with that yellow rock, this yellow guard in front. Then I'll have to go by really close to it.
Much curlier, but
I see it. Oh, it might be right. It's quite good.
Oh, yeah. How good is that?
And is he lying too?
He's lying too, and he's got a biter. Wilser's just gonna give him give up his deuce and lick his wounds here after that pistol.
What a shot. You see Peter there.
You don't even know which
one to sweep. Benoit Schwartz pulling out the really big shot when needed.
Mark of a champion right there. Make the ones that you have to.
That's really great. And now really, so that was a really great shot, but I mean that's changing a really bad situation to a actually really good situation. The biter, the shot rock, well the two shot rocks. Bullshit has to hit and stay. Hit and stay. Lie second, third, and force Benoit to play a draw for two, which is a really good situation. I like to play draws for two.
Mm-hmm. I'd take that.
Yeah, I'll take that.
After what we were looking at last rock, I think if you told Benoit you'll have a draw for two, he goes, yes, I will take that every time.
Yeah. I mean, we're talking about a draw to the 8 foot also. We're not talking about a draw to the pin, so.
Yeah. And Ulsrud has to stick this. It's kind of funny. It seems sometimes those hits in the back of the house become a little more challenging because guys just aren't used to playing them. They can't see them as nice. But that being said, I don't expect Ulsrud to be too far off the mark. But if he rolls out, it'd be a hit for three.
So important to stay there.
Has to stick this, otherwise what a change in the game. They don't look very happy right now. Oh yeah, he'll be good.
And he stays.
Good shot.
Well, good shot, really good shot. He was stressed there
too.
Yeah,
it didn't seem like they were too happy when that was coming in.
He didn't really... Well, he played a really good takeout weight, I think. Totally controlled. And that really allowed him to stay.
Mm-hmm.
Playing those hits and stay at the back of the house is quite difficult because you have those two extra meters to go.
Yep.
Rock curls that much more.
I think De Cruz is going to be pretty satisfied with this, a draw for two. Get back in the game, tie it up after four. Still got a long ways to go to win the game, but like I say, there's always a chance. They can force him in five. Sitting good going into six. He misses that shot. Probably pulls some handshakes. I don't look too concerned here. Little half sweep into the house.
Nice shot.
Crowd seems pretty happy here about that. I guess it'd be hometown crowd almost. Home country crowd.
Well, yeah. And I think they're quite excited with the result there, that end, especially the way it was looking after Torger's rocks, and even after Thomas's first rock.
Yep, for sure. Yeah, what a great shot making there for Thomas to come off the wall into the pocket, and then Benoit to make that quadruple or triple or whatever the heck it was.
Yeah, raise triple. Yeah, I think
raise triple. So after four ends, I guess we're tied up here in Baden at the Curling Champions Tour first event of the season. 3-3, De Cruz, Ulsrud. Ulsrud will have hammer, going into five.
So we're live at this Curling Champions Tour event, and my name is Roger Gulka, and I'm commentating this game with Kurt Myers. Always
happy
a pleasure
to be here. Like I said earlier, Roger and I and the De Cruz boys go back a few years into juniors when they took it to us in the semi-final of the Worlds. Two years go by and now I don't feel like I need to punch him in the face anymore though, eh?
Oh, it's okay. Thank you so much. Very kindness.
Yes. Just off the guard there. Found is that in these games, about the fifth end here, fourth, fifth end, that super fast glide that you see in the second and third starts to wear off, and you kind of have to make sure you throw them there. Not as much sweep, can't bring them as far, but these guys seem to be handling that really well.
Yeah, so now we're back in this fifth end. Ulstrud has the last draw. Back in the start situation with Forns left to play. Tied with Last Rock. And that objective of scoring a two.
Oh, just robbed it again.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Well, it's... The speed was really good. See how curls really just at the end there.
I guess they just had to sweep harder. Just wasn't sweeping hard enough.
Yeah, I think so. I'll ask Christopher Svaa to press a bit more on this broom.
Yep. I think Christopher is engaged to be married. That's what I heard. He got engaged this summer, so congratulations to him.
Slapp back i krisen, så da må han rulle. Da blir det guffet for han. Spiller han lyd? Gjør du det?
Well, I think Ulstrud would like to have a little hit and roll to the inside. Which would force Team De Cruz to play a run back takeout.
Shaping up not too bad for De Cruz right now. Got those nice tight centers that he can use, like you say, to run back if need be. And hopefully plug off that forefoot eventually and force Ulstrud to one.
Well, they have the center covered, which is good when you don't have the last rock. Christopher Svazrock just didn't curl enough, and now Peter just asking once again a little hit and roll. I think it's not that important if they get the roll that much. Just get the hit for sure. Decline weight.
Little nose hit here. From Claudio. Nice shot.
Peter says it's very good. He's quite happy. Maybe that's the moment for Thomas to play defensive. Well, what he could try and do maybe is actually blank this end. If he finds out that there's no possible real way to score, a blank wouldn't be so bad. He would keep the hammer into the sixth. And I always find that scoring the sixth end is really important. Even if you score just a one, if you just take a 1-point lead in the sixth, and if you manage to force the other team to score, you can even let them score two, you'll be one down with last rock.
Yep.
And that's not such an uncomfortable situation.
No. Yep.
A little bit of a misfire there, I think.
Yeah. Well, at least they opened it. But not that much.
And that overlap never seems to be good either. There's if Peter makes this one good, there'll be no run back even available.
Okay.
So a good chance for Team De Cruz to take the advantage of this end.
Six.
He said, I just want to be six. Just said it in German. But six means top of the forefoot.
Frank.
That's
T-set.
Inbound.
Set. Plutôt 7.
Whoa, whoa.
Plutôt 7.
Folks, they're a little calling hot right now. Are they calling good?
They're calling T-line a bit over T-line so far.
Looks like they're working it in there nicely. This looks like it's going to be a pistol.
Change the call. He said six.
Oh, yeah. Thank God, boys.
Sweep it too much.
Yeah, 6 inches higher than that might have been better, eh? But I guess they wanted to make sure they're buried.
Yeah. Well, sometimes, actually, if your rock is going to be behind the T-line, it's better not to have it buried.
Yeah.
So, see teams that sweep just to try and get it buried, but if you're behind the T-line buried, it's actually worse than if you're behind the T-line not buried. So.
Yeah, good point.
Shot.
I think Thomas wants him to sweep.
Mr. Peterson was ready actually to let that rock down, and but I had to run back to sweep. Lazy sweeper.
What's that?
Lazy sweeper.
Lazy sweeper.
Look.
Is that what he said?
No, no. Oh. That's me.
Yeah, I think they're going to throw a guard here. Or? I think that'll work pretty good, eh?
Yeah. Looks like they just want to block the center now. Just play a guard. Here confirms that they're shot. So just center guard.
My French is no good, but I think they're saying deux means two. Okay. Perfect. Nice shot. There's that whole overlap I was talking about earlier. It looks like it's going to cause him some grief here.
Oh, Tim McCurs has gone for the steal. If they manage to keep the situation the way it is, the maximum Ulstrud can score is a one.
Mm-hmm.
And it, so far, it looks like a difficult one.
It certainly does. They keep blocking off that draw, too.
Yeah, those corner guards really like cut all the lines to get the forefoot. You have to get pass them by really tight.
Yep. Yeah, it's been a fun game to watch so far. Back and forth. You gonna try a triple peel or here, or are they running that in there? I think the triple. We're trying to get that stagger off and remove that center guard.
Whoa!
Not bad.
Yeah, Well, that already is something. And it opens the possibility for the run back on the yellow.
Not too sure what I missed there.
Little shrew made a funny noise.
We're going to try another guard. A little tighter to take away that run back on the yellow there, it looks like.
Ça pour éviter ça. Okay.
Just quiet, huh?
Mine, c'est bien. Un peu large.
Deux.
Un peu large.
Juste deux.
Place, plus. Place. Oh, oh, oh.
Il y a deux, trois.
Faudra finir, hein. Ligne, oui. Ligne, oui, sûr. Ouais. Fini. Très fort, Rigo. Ouais. Toujours, toujours, toujours.
You want to curl a bit more. Be on the center line.
Okay. Okay.
Looks like the result's good.
Tout le monde, tout le monde.
Mais c'est grave.
Hein?
Well, it doesn't seem like you can go in between those two rocks.
Just considering, I think the run back there, he probably doesn't know if he wants to play it now or after. Or on his last one, but...
Well, there is that run back directly, or that shot he was just showing to do... to throw the yellow onto the red center guard and... Try and maybe get all the guards out.
Halla tjukk I tjukkeste laget, Torgeir.
Nei.
Halla nære, tror jeg.
Looks like they're gonna attempt it. If this is made, I guess Benoit might have to make it back on the one he just threw. See how it shakes out. Maybe he'll have a draw, too.
Gider du å skippe foran, eller? Ja. Kan jeg bare treffe den gule uansett? Det er ikke noe bak der. Det passer meg best, nemlig. Hard.
Ja.
Hard.
Oh. Ja.
Hard.
Ja.
Ren.
Okay, just playing the double peel. Make sure they score, I guess.
Peter's saying that they have a good chance to steal that end.
Mm-hmm. So they're going to throw up a guard here? I like it.
Yeah, I like the guard, I think.
If you even make it half guarded, it's pretty close to being good enough. If you get it about there, and you make it good, you make it a little tougher for him to get a point. And if he miscues it all, he might actually steal two. If he ends up picking it off or whatnot, he might just draw to the pin. I like it.
Well, Peter was talking about what side of the rock was better to leave open, if ever. We were thinking about the outside.
Mm-hmm.
And
yep.
Well, the other option would have been to play it safe, you know, hit that yellow, roll out, but then you kind of offer the one to Ulstrud, and there they have that chance to steal, so I kind of like that attitude that they actually jump on that chance, try and take it.
Yeah, you don't get a chance to steal on Ulstrud very often, so when you get the chance, I think you got to take advantage.
You got to go for it.
Hammer advantage, right?
Yeah, I agree. I think you really got to go for it. I mean, we're not talking also about a huge risk.
No, you're right, yeah.
Racket!
Just have to get a guard on there pretty good.
Calling it wide.
Once the break point hits, the boys will have to sleep for hard.
You want to go? You want to get that swing at the end?
Nice shot. Really might right. have it, eh? I wonder if he's going to try.
Well, I think that he's leaving a decent possibility for Ulstrud to score one. I think he's leaving the two, though. The two is still possible, I think.
You know, I think I'd attempt it. The draw to the pin for one you aren't going to make every day or all the time. And this shot you're not going to make all the time, but this one has a little more reward.
Yeah, well, they can play that weight that Torger was just showing. I mean, back 8 foot. Bump the yellow one, if possible, on the nose. Bump the red one far enough to score two. I mean, if worse comes to worse, you score one. So, I mean,
yep,
it's all right.
Yep. Agreed.
And if we really take the worst-case scenario, I mean, you get a one stolen on you. Well, you're one down, last rock in the sixth. If you score a two, one up without, leave a one in the seven. And
yep. Then you're good, yeah, absolutely. It's great. It's a great end scoreboard to try getting two and really setting the stage into the last half of the game here.
But I think that he has to play that shot. He has to go for two. I mean, every chance you have to score two, really have to take it if it's makeable.
And I think this is makeable.
I think it's makeable too. Seems like there's a good
about
swing
a half
at
a
the
rock
end.
And you get that late swing with backhouse weight. I think yeah. I think Thomas Ulstrud actually probably makes this one for fun.
You got to make sure you pass the guard. A little bit fast, maybe. Nice and wide.
I think he's just fine.
Close. Boy, and that's peach.
How's that
oh,
for
that's
a shot?
Great shot.
Nice shot for two.
Wow. Well, congratulations, Thomas. That was really nice.
He takes the commanding lead going in the last three ends. He's up two. Another nice deuce. Nice shot by the Ulstrud team, so it's 5-3 after five ends, and DeCruz will have hammer going into the sixth here.
What a, I mean, how calm he just stayed on that one. And yeah, the, I mean, Benoit's guard was, we could say, good because it was there, but it really left that chance, and you don't want to leave that chance.
That's right.
I think that he should have been how Peter was showing before, maybe top 12. That would have been probably the best weight for that rock.
Yep.
The sweepers wanted to take it, but it was a bit wide, so they had to leave it curl.
Mm-hmm. And I guess that's it's one of those things too, wide and light. It's not a good combination on a guard, but everyone seems to think those guards are automatics. But to put them in a good place, you really need good weight and let your sweepers work it into place. Like you say, if you add another 5-6 feet of weight, that'd have curled up nicely. Just a little light and wide.
Yep.
Looks like the skipper Peter had to go and take care of some business in the change room. Playing a shot or two with three guys. Guard Mr. Tanner.
Spill full 12 der dit vi skal.
Ja, greit, det er enig den.
du ikke lov forbi Ege?
Ja, men det Om den isen åpne det, altså. Nå skal jeg like linje.
Fin fart.
Ja. Nå holder jeg til gang til deg. Tøytere, tøytere, tøytere. Hard! Nå går han inn I deg.
Hard!
Hard! Hard! Hard! Hard! Hard! Hard!
Hard! Hard! Kom inn! Hard! Kom inn! Kom inn! Kom inn! Kom inn! Kom inn!
Want to get in the house.
Use a little opening here for Peter to try that flop under at least and get it off the forefoot. Yellowstone off the forefoot and maybe open up that corner and he can develop some points around the corner guard.
Yeah, not such a great opening from Norway's lead. Conley a bit fast.
There she comes. Nice shot.
Yeah, good shot.
Var lettest, gå rett på shot eller via egen? Ja. Vi spiller den da med hack, og så hvis vi går I, så splitter vi hvert fall I to egne.
Hellstrud saying that we can play a hack weight, remove that red, and if worse comes to worse, split our rock.
Yeah. I think it's reasonable.
I like that call.
Absolutely.
Plan A, plan B.
Yep. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Nære, 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 nære.
Got a little curling to do here.
Bra spill. Bra spill.
I think Peter will probably ignore that either way.
Yeah, well, he has to create something now. He can't just destroy all the Norwegian rocks and play.
Yep.
He's just saying, I don't like that yellow one, though.
I don't blame him.
So, like a hit and roll. Set up a double corner guard. We'll just roll on the other side, as he's just showing right now. Yeah. And, I understand that he doesn't like that rock. Huh? I think it's the most dangerous one.
I agree. It's but at the same time, it's
no man.
Again, those hit and rolls can be tough. But mind you, if he even noses it, that's a pretty good shot, I think.
Well, he's two down with the last rock, and with three ends left to play, including this one. So what he really wants to do is make sure he stays in the game. So by removing that guard, I mean he basically removes the only threat for a steal.
Right, and again, if he can open up that center, roll that. That's a nice shot. Now he's got two corners. He's got some good things going on there, I think.
Yeah, if he can get one nice and tucked behind there, I think Ilstrud will remove at least one of them. Can't leave that the way it is.
Nope. That's for sure.
Yeah. One corner is enough to score two. So situation so far looking fine for the Swiss.
Ren. Wow, wow, wow. Var det ren? Yep, yep. Hard! Hard!
That might be a three ball coming now.
Oh, that's...
Still some good shots to be made, but...
That's actually quite a bad shot.
Yeah, it worked out really bad, didn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's really bad. Now, not only he puts a corner guard, but he guards the rock behind the tee line. Suddenly from being just those kinds of rocks that can annoy you if suddenly you really don't have to miss your last rock, well then suddenly it can become an advantage as
yep.
Good backing for your own.
Everyone seems pretty happy so far.
Need that big swing at the end. Here it comes.
She starts working in there.
You can see it curl there.
Oh, yeah. That's a nice shot.
Peter's happy.
That's what you got to do when you get a mistake out of the opposition. Really pound them back quick. And that was a nice shot by Claudio.
Ulstrud.
Well,
probably Torger can see about, I don't know, at least a third of it from the hack. The danger is, to, well, you can either hit the guard through or get the jam, so you really got to make sure you hit that one precisely on the inside.
Shot.
A great shot.
And actually rolling that to the button helps a lot too. Because at the end of the day, the best defense might be lying too at the end of the end for Ulstrud.
Looking at the hit and roll. Hit and stay frozen on that yellow. So as we see in this end, controlled risk taken by Peter. They need rocks in play, but they don't need to go all in.
There's lots of end left too. That attack point can wait until even Peter's last or even Benoit's first if it needs to be. So I like the call.
Well, it's not the moment to either win or blow it.
Yeah, that's for sure.
You got to make sure you stay in the game. If they score one, I mean, well, in theory, what you would like to do is force a one and take it to the last end for the extra end and then hope.
Yep. And I guess then you give yourself a 20% chance of winning, and is what Jerry had sent us there. Whereas if you go all in now and you give up two or three, steal two or three, you probably move that to about 0% chance of winning. So I'll take 20% over that. So that's right. You got to stay in the game.
And you never know. A mistake can always come.
Absolutely.
By definition, you never count on the opponent's mistakes. But
you may need it every once in a while.
They happen. As we see that, can't be considered as a mistake. Well, a half mistake. And half mistakes are already good enough.
Mm-hmm.
I was saying that you never count those mistakes, but when they happen, you really have to jump on that chance. And I think that's what they're thinking about now. All right, now we got the house for us. Where are we going to put that rock so that we can get that too?
Yep. And I like their call here of maybe going around the tighter red one, just for the simple fact that they've been playing around that other one a few shots, and it seems that Ulstrud knows it well and won't miss much there, and trying to change the shot for Thomas, I guess.
Well, the advantage of the red one is that, first of all, it's their own guard, so if ever they touch it as close to the house, they can push it in, so at least they can lie one. There's also the possibility of either always splitting a bit.
Mm-hmm. That'd be great.
The inconvenience that is though it's very close to the house, so if they manage to get behind, the run back will not be that difficult. Or they will have less space to curl and get nicely tucked in behind it. The inconvenience of the other one, of the yellow guard, is it's far enough to play a hack weight, take it.
That's right.
So they managed to get actually nice to behind the red
guard. I guess I was wrong.
The red guard.
Looks like they're playing the yellow.
No.
Yeah.
No.
But if they get it behind the red one, nicely, then it's...
Yep.
You know that red one may be in a position that you can split too if the opportunity arises.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good draw from Peter. Probably would have preferred to be at that position in front of the T-line, but it's already buried, forcing Ulstrud to, I think he's got to play freeze.
Looks like it.
I'm always like... This heavy, this shot, this heavy. From the beginning. I have a feeling though,
I have a feeling that my number six might be a little slower, a little more cutting than this one. I have a feeling.
T'as dit quoi?
J'ai l'impression que ma numéro 6, elle est un peu plus lente que celle-là.
Ok.
His sixth round is a bit slower than the other one.
What do you think of the 3 blank for him?
It's
around. Hvordan glir utover her nå, tror jeg?
Ja, det around 14-3.
14, cirka.
Han ligger jo, vi holder jo med T-line nå, eller skal vi lokke den helt ned?
Ja, jeg synes lokken på, men...
Ja.
Det passer ikke å gå for tidlig, også, så vi får...
Mye
toppa.
Just trying to freeze here and choking off that red one behind the tee.
Curly,
we
come. Curly, we come.
That looks hot, doesn't it?
Hey.
Oh boy, there she starts working. Might be okay though, huh?
Might just do it, but he's gonna get the bump. Yeah, he got the bump. I don't want.
I think he might be able to hit that and roll in if he'd want to. What do you think?
He's not very happy with that. He knows he's giving them that chance that they're looking for. Score two and even potential three if he makes a really good hit and roll.
Yep.
Yeah.
Looks like they're the plan just to tap it out and see if they can roll behind the corner and lie two.
On est passé assez loin, les gars. Et puis j'étais genre neuf, quoi.
And Thomas will need to make a good one again.
Juste, on essaye ça.
Ouais.
En plein. Même si ça fait comme ça, c'est pas grave, hein.
Ouais.
Même si, tac.
10 quand même.
Ça, ça va aussi. Si, si la jaune, elle touche la rouge, c'est pas grave. Hein?
So, backline weight for Benoit.
Juste backline.
Neuf-dix.
Ouais.
Picked.
Oh. Arrive à la mettre dedans.
That's not a fun way to watch a game.
I know.
Jeez.
Yeah. Can you get it in?
I know.
Right.
Okay, man.
That's too bad. That was setting up nicely for the De Cruz team, and now Alzrud has to do is lie two here, and Benoit will be drawing for one.
Now,
boys aren't happy about that one.
I understand that they're frustrated. You know, it's the Murphy's Law. It's always on those really important shots that you get a pick.
Isn't that the truth?
And that was a really crucial shot. At least they're laughing now, so I like the attitude of that team, really.
Yeah.
I understand you're a bit frustrated. It's annoying, but in the end, what can you do?
What can you do? You're right. And not by being frustrated, it's just going to harm you going forward. So you got to let it go and move on and make sure it doesn't harm the team.
Well, you can't do anything about it anymore, but you know that you can do something with your next shot.
That's right.
Basically. You're saying, it's so annoying because we could have been so lying so good.
yeah, that's the problem too, isn't it? He makes that one, boy. Probably gets a couple points, maybe.
Well, I think that kind of kills their chances for two now.
Yeah.
Gods of curling have been kind to them.
Looks like those are just going to go top eight, I think, on the center line, and should be enough to force them and make them draw around something or hit, decide what he wants to play.
Linja fin.
Hvor langt?
Not curling too much yet. There she busts out a little bit, but...
Making sure it's behind the T line.
And that does the job.
No double.
Huh?
And that's going to be, a draw for one, I suppose.
I think so.
Aye.
Yeah, I just got my brother just showed me his phone here, and I never realized it, but I guess it is a pretty slow game. We're 2 hours in the sixth end. Didn't realize the boys were playing slow.
Yeah, well, there's been a lot of drawing, a lot of rucks in play in general.
Yep, and when you're playing for a championship, probably slow down a little bit.
Yeah. Get your focus.
On l'a joué plusieurs fois, celui-là aussi. C'est demi.
Looks like he's going to hit, eh? He must not be feeling the draw weight quite as good as he'd like to.
Oh, they're calling it a bit fast. Just say clean it. Got to make sure not to get it picked this time.
Yeah, no kidding.
That's a perfect nose hit.
That'll do to keep the boys in the game after six ends here.
Yeah, the crowd clapping and 1 point for Team De Cruz. Bring up the score to 5-4. Starting the seventh end, and the Norwegians now in a good situation, leading by 1-2 ends left to go, and they have the last rock. You're watching right now the final of the Baden Masters. It's a curling championster event. My name is Roger Gulka, and I'm commentating with Kurt Myers.
Good to be here. It's been a good game so far, and hopefully it finishes off with some excitement. Guess Ulsrud will try to blank or get two, and De Cruz will be all out steel. I guess a force wouldn't be the end of the world, but.
So, tell me a bit, because you're from Saskatchewan.
That's right, yep.
You're playing with Team Laycock.
Yep.
So usually we had Brad Gushu coming here, so first year to this tournament.
Yeah, we decided we wanted to start a little earlier, and we heard this event was great, and so we wanted to travel to Europe a little bit and play against some of the teams here, and it was a great event. Not a bad thing to say about it, and hopefully we'll be back sometime, but wanted to stretch out our season, play in Europe, and we picked a good one.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad that you're enjoying Switzerland.
Absolutely. It's a beautiful country. We were able to take a few days before and travel, see some of the sights in Zurich and in Baden here, and it's been absolutely beautiful, and the hospitality and the food have been wonderful. So
I'm glad you enjoy the food.
Yeah, it's... maybe it was the players' lounge that they were feeding us, but whoever was in charge of that did a darn good job, because that was every time you go down there, it was something new and it was delicious. So,
all good. And so that's your first tournament of the season.
Yep. So that's right. It was like I say, the first one of the season, and now we'll have a week off, and then we'll play most of our other events at home or in Canada there. So, played well. Finished 3-1 and I just out of the playoffs, but that's how it goes, and sure like to be playing out there, but as long as we played well, we performed well, and that's all you can do.
So are you already thinking about coming back next year?
Oh, it's crossed our mind, that's for sure. We like it. It fits well into our schedule, like I say, because it's so early. We can start early, and we can spread out our season a little bit, so we don't have so many weekends in a row throughout the winter. So we're definitely considering it, that's for sure. A little bit of a break there for De Cruz. I think Harvard came up a little late on the draw and put up another guard, so it's never a bad thing when you're down.
Eneste jeg tror at vi skal kline den ned der, nesten dra ving her da. Vi skal kjøre den sånn og prøve på toppen der.
Okay. Sånn som det ligger nå, så kan vi gå rett på gul.
Ja. Dra hit da, så.
Hvis vi drar vingen andre rundt, så tar vi bare de to nærmeste.
Ving her.
Det alt for mye.
Looks like they're just gonna split the house here, get one in the rings, and probably go to peel on Christopher's.
Kjøla oppover der på innen, kjøla hvertfall litt utover.
Da har jeg du enda med det i begynnelsen.
Here's how Edvard Pedersen
playing
lead for that Norwegian team. Silver medalist at the Olympics in 2010 in Vancouver. Finished fifth at the previous Olympics in Sochi, losing the tiebreaker to team David Murdoch, who was playing here, and lost to Peter De Cruz in the quarterfinals, having a six taken on them.
Oh, jeez. And reigning world champs, I guess, too, is the Ulzrud team, huh?
Yes, yes. So the team made a good performance. They probably were a bit disappointed with their Olympic performance. I think they were really looking forward to having medal and hopefully gold. But gold was taken by Canada in men's and women's with amazing Jennifer Jones. And
yeah, they sure put on a clinic that week. Jacobs started a little slow, but they played well. And even throughout the trials process in Canada, those teams, I don't think you could argue that they weren't the best. So,
yeah, Brad Jacobs really. At the end of the tournament, they were really totally different team than at the beginning. It was, they ended being unbeatable.
Yep. Yeah. And that's they won the Breyer, the Canadian Championship, the year before, and then went through the trials too. And man, when they play good, they are really unbeatable. So nice shot. Open her up a little bit there.
Cap, tu veux revenir comme ça? Ok. Cap, là ça va aussi.
Yeah, Team De Cruz, who has participated for the first time in an international competition this season. That was in the World Championships in Beijing, in China, where they had a really good result, winning bronze. Beating Canada, actually, Kevin Kui. We like to beat Canada in those playoffs, actually.
Yeah, laugh it up there, Roger. You pick it on me.
yeah, it's just like in the good old days. And yep. Well, anyway.
Head. Yeah, no, that was that's like I say, that De Cruz team is a team that seems to get better every game, and they're a powerful team.
Yeah, I think in Switzerland they're really one of the most talented teams, and they really showed how they can progress fast. I mean, they joined the elite now 4 years ago, actually, and change seconds, but
well, you got the upgrade. Now you're the professional broadcaster, hey?
And now I just look at them play, and at the end I tell them what they did right and wrong. But they started quite well. I mean, they were a bit disappointed their first year at the men's Swiss Championships, finishing fourth or fifth, and then they managed to get better results, and they finally won it last year. So this is actually their fourth year now in the, in the men's.
Yeah, I find it's just one of those things too. I mean, we went through that a little bit too. Is he kind of that whole, you got to learn how to lose before you can win, and kind of know what you need to do to get through games, get through competitions, and it's a learning process for sure.
Well, I think their backing is very solid. Peter and Benoit are really compatible in the house, and with the sweeping they have.
Yep, for sure.
And the team looks good on the ice, I think.
Like it.
And when you take Benoit's demeanor out there, it's pretty unreal. He just seems to go with the flow and just continues to make shots and never gets too high or too low on his emotions and just lets it ride. And I think that's what makes a good skip. or a good last rock thrower, I should say.
Du har hele?
Nei, nesten 90.
I think that might have been.
Du spiller med litt solid vanlig, så 2/3 jo dobbelt. Spiller 11?
Ja.
For å treffe så mye som mulig, men du får den med 2/3, så du spinner inn hit, tror jeg.
Hvilken spiller da?
Men,
det 11 spiller ut allikevel, tror
jeg. Du ikke precis?
Ja, ok.
Du velger, hvis du tror du ruller ut uansett.
Jeg tror jeg ruller ut
uansett, ja. Ja, spill pil da. Det var mye mer å gå på. Enig.
Looks like they're gonna try the double and roll here.
Yep. Rent. Whoa.
Torger with the heat.
Whoa. Yep.
Pistol. Is it gonna hang around?
Well, if he hangs around, that's really good.
Oh yeah.
Well played.
Now, yeah, I think that's what they got to do is hit that one maybe, but. Steel isn't looking so great.
Not anymore.
For the crews, that's for sure. Not sure what to think here with the guard. It's might be able to put it in a position where that peel might be tough on one of the reds would be, or onto the yellows in the corners. Your only chance, I think. Otherwise, they'll just keep peeling, and at some point, you got to hit, and they'll have a draw to the 12 foot. Ulsrud would have a draw to the 12 foot to take a commanding lead into 8. So it's not a real good situation for De Cruz here. See what they can make of it.
Two.
Un peu large. Non, c'est bon, ligne. Ligne bien. En tout cas, deux, Val. Minimum deux. Hein. Minimum deux. Ouais. Encore, Val. Ouais. Toujours.
Big shot.
Yeah. Good guard from Pierre De Cruz.
What the doctor ordered there.
Ja, spill vant da, så du...
Det ingen hensyn til å ligge der, for det.
Nei.
Da får du bare en dyp dragning.
Der og vant. Gutta holder den, Torger. Yep.
Can you try a little tap out?
Hardt! Rent. Whoa.
You know, that's if you think about, if I was De Cruz, I'd be pretty happy with what they played there. Just for the simple fact that they can open up the steel now again if they play this shot, but versus the if Lizard would have peeled that, I think they would have a good chance at making sure that opens, that front stays open, and they have a shot for one, maybe two.
Well, I think that Ulsrud has to peel that guard because there's a big chance of sending on to those two yellows.
Good point. Yes, and that would be bad. You're right. And then
so you have to make sure you avoid the jam and roll out.
No picnic.
Alright, watch out.
Привет, Россия.
This.
Okay, Lynn, c'est bon.
Whoa. 17.
Ouais.
Plutôt 7.
Whoa. Attention. Nettoyez quand même. Nettoie.
8.
Nettoie, Valentin.
8.
10. Juste 5.
7.
Oh. Juste 7. Lynn, c'est bon. Ouais. Yep.
11.
Kom
igjen. Good shot.
Kjøk etter oss. Kjøk.
Nå går tight etter med myk hack. Ja, det der kører ikke mye, altså, men vi må inn på her, tror jeg.
Looks like Ozrud might be able to just tap it out again, hey?
Noe sånt så trenger jeg ikke mer enn det, Torgi.
Har du en flika,
da? Ja, jeg vet det.
Det kjører litt etter garden nå.
Yeah, I think somebody was wondering about why Ulstrud didn't peel that guard. So, yeah, we were thinking about maybe they were afraid of jamming it on one of their yellows on the side. That's my only rational explanation, I think.
Yeah, I would agree. That's probably what the thought process was, because that to me, that's the only danger rock on that sheet at the time. So... And you know, even if hindsight's a beautiful thing, but even if you look and he does make that jam, again, it might be sitting better for a point. And really, at the end of the day, all Ulsrud needs is a point. And that center guard is allowing De Cruz maybe the opportunity to steal. So I would agree that the peel would have been my first option. But again, I'm sitting here talking about the game and they're playing it. So.
Nære!
Wow! Ingenting! Wow! Håvard, følg litt rann, du.
Take it as far as you can. Take it as far as you can.
Well, I think it's going to be either steal a one or handshakes.
Yeah, it's...
By the look of things like here, hey?
The problem with that guard is just reasonably far away.
Not a great place to hide behind, is it?
Yeah. I need to be at the top of the forefront. I think that whatever Benoit plays, Ulstrud will have a shot at it. I mean, it's his chance to finish the game now. So pressure's on now for Benoit.
I think if this is Benoit's last, yeah. I think they're just trying to go just top eight here. Get her perfectly buried, a little overburied maybe to the... Would be okay, but... Looks like it's looking good. Nice shot. Stop curling a little bit there.
Yeah, great shot from Benoit Schwartz.
That is a nice shot. What would you play there, Roger? Is it worth a little bit there? Just draw the 4 foot for one.
I don't know. I'd go for it.
I think I would too.
I would play either a peel, a run back, or something. I don't know, a hack weight, whatever. Because, I mean, that's his chance to win the game. He has a shot to win the game. So, I mean, you take it. And if he misses it completely, the worst case scenario is to steal a one, tied with last rock.
Couldn't agree more. That's the thing is, the risk is not that much to try it. And if you make it, game over. You miss it, well, you're still going to win. Like you're still going to win 80% of the time, like Jerry said earlier. If you're tied up with hammer going to last end, so I think it's the right call.
Yeah, you want to take that 8% chance.
Yep, exactly.
So we give me y'all also again. Ja, så det akkurat en som var her forrige.
Det bare sikte på kosten med riktig fart, det ikke verre enn
det egentlig. Greit.
Looks like he's just getting committed to the shot here. With the chance probably to win the game.
Would it be the last rock of the game?
Doesn't look like she's curling yet. There it comes.
Close.
Gosh, that's got to be pretty close.
It looks really close. Is it going to be enough?
St- Steal a one.
Is it going to be enough? No. No, 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 no. And that's the steal of one. And that was how to pull it out of the fire there.
Yes. Unreal.
Peter DeCruz's team are quite good at doing that. And how to give yourself a chance to still win it. So we saw the stats. They theoretically have a 20% chance of winning against 80% for Ilstrud, but game's on.
Game on. At least they're still playing, right? Chip in a chair. It's all they need.
Yeah, I'm quite excited because that would have been quite disappointing to see that final end up this way.
Yeah, we're gonna at least see the last rock.
Yeah, last rock winner. Last stand.
Okay.
Still liking the odds if I'm Ulzrud, but just never know.
Okay. Okay, fuck.
Valentin will start. So this usual last end tied strategy. One team will try and jam the game as much as possible, and the other one will try and clean everything up. Basically, what you want to do is that you want to close in the center and put a rock behind in the forefoot. I mean, at that level, if you don't have a rock buried in the forefoot, you have basically 0% chance of stealing. Can only expect to pick the player to fall down or something.
Yep. And the two strategies are pretty clear for both teams. The Cruz is get anything they can going, and Ulzrud is get everything gone fast. So,
by definition, every rock in play, whether it's yellow or red, is good for De Cruz, and every rock it's and bad for Ulzrud. Yeah.
Yep.
So right now we see the free guard zone rule in action.
Looks like they're just going to try a little tick to get it off the center line a little bit here and really open things up.
That's a shot Havard Pettersson really fancies. Leeds really became so much better at that shot.
Yeah, they have been, haven't they? It's almost an automatic now.
Yeah, really. It's which actually would be an argument to put that. The free guard zone rule to five rocks.
Yep.
Because I mean, when I was started curling, it was a really difficult shot to play. Everybody says most hardest shot to play. And now you see all those leads, you know, who practice that shot over and over again and get really good at it. Here we see a successful one.
Yep. Yeah, it's for sure. Got an interesting stat from Jerry here since 2011. Our 10-11 season, Thomas Ulzrud is 18-4 when tied with Hammer going into last end, so he's feeling pretty good about this. But maybe a more interesting stat is De Cruz is actually 6-12 when tied without Hammer. So looks like about a 33% chance of winning for De Cruz, which is slightly above the average.
And we really want to thank Jerry for all those stats.
Yeah, he's a stat man, that's for sure. He's talking with Jerry a lot over the years, and he's a baseball guy, so he likes numbers. And so he's been doing a lot for the sport, and he does a lot to grow the game. Works well, I think, with the Curling Champions Tour as well. So thank you, Jerry.
I think so. Something happened there. Apparently a rock was touched or something. I haven't seen really.
I don't know.
But we can see also how curling works out. There's no umpire, no referee. Both teams just agree when there's something happened, a breach of the rules.
I'll leave you with
we see the skips all agreeing, and it's quite friendly.
Yeah.
No tackling in the...
Everyone agrees where it ends up and where it needs to go and move on.
And DeCruz now in a reasonably good situation. I mean, got to make sure not to waste it. Have to put a good guard in front of that red.
Yep. Yeah, they got a chance here, actually. Hey, nice tight guard right off the center line.
Oh, really hard. Has to go through.
Just needs to get over the hog line, Claudio. That's
so important.
Got to go, boys. Oh, no. That's too bad.
Okay. And that's an unusual mistake from Claudio Petz, who's been really solid all the weekend. And there, misses a really, really important shot.
Don't want to say that's the game, but it might be, huh?
That's a kind of mistake that you really don't want to have.
But that's curling, and humans aren't perfect, right? So,
well, it happens. Yeah, that's when you see how competitive teams react to those kinds of situations. I mean, you see sometimes beginners teams, you know, getting angry at each other, yelling at each other. Why did you miss? Why did you do that? And there you see they just say, well, okay, next rock.
Yep.
And you keep your calm. Don't get angry at your players. You know they don't make on purpose.
You know they don't do it on purpose, and you know they aren't bad curlers. It just sometimes you miss. If you knew you were going to make them all, we wouldn't even have to go out there, would we?
If it were easy, everybody would play curling.
That's right.
So Peter wants a long guard.
Ben,
one and one means a long guard close to hog line. This big thick line you see there.
I think the idea with that long guard was to create a jam situation potentially and see what happens, but it's unlikely. Oh, swept it the whole way and still needed to curl.
That's it.
No. Those ones are tough to call. They're 25-foot angle runs to a dot.
You more or less have a less than a centimeter, I say, surface on the rock where you can hit it to make it. I know how you talk. You talk in inches?
I do generally talk in inches.
All right.
Centimeter, half an inch, I guess.
About, yeah.
All right, less than that, but.
So less than half an inch.
Quarter, about a 2.5 centimeters to an inch. So whatever that translates to. I'm not the mathematician. You probably are, though, huh?
Wait, how many inches make 1 foot?
12.
12?
Or, yes, 12 3 inches.
Feet is 1 yard?
I think so.
Okay.
But I'm not. In Canada, we kind of got a mix of everything. We do feet, inches, imperial, and metric, but. Another nice shot.
Pulstrom was thinking about not going for the guard, which I would think would have been a mistake.
I don't disagree with you there.
So, of course, Pulstrom usually doesn't do those big mistakes often.
Looks like this ends playing out pretty well for Olsrud.
No stress. Those are just routine shots for those players. I mean, on top of that, the ice is really good. Quite nice and straight if you throw that hard. So,
yeah, there isn't a lot of stress when you can rely on the ice doing what you expect it to. And when you got good ice, that's what it allows you to do.
Yeah. So it's very rare to see some of those peels missed. I think often, the more often when they're misses, the guys actually just hit it on the nose.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
I know Jerry has a statistic on that.
All right, that's another new one for you there, Jerry.
Yeah, a statistic on how peels are missed, and how often.
Un peu plus large. Whoa.
Même.
Place, beaucoup de place.
Même chose.
He's been crunching the numbers for the last 5 years.
Yeah, he could have actually a statistic on how many peels are missed at that level.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, probably less than 10%, maybe 5%.
I would agree.
Hva vurderer du å prøve deg på? Nei, det ikke noe bedre vinke nå.
Another peel from Torger.
Yep. Rent, rent. Bra, bra.
Nu blir det tio kvar. Jag ska se när jag kan få skjuta ett läsning där.
I think Peter will put up another guard.
Okej. Okay. Tre där. Vill jag att så ser det sett att det reste un peu plus au centre. Tre där. Moi j'aime bien en plein centre. Juste là. Trois, comme ça peut-être qu'il...
They're thinking maybe put it somewhere that Ozer will have a catcher on it. I think at the end of the day, all Peter wants to do is probably make him look at a couple and decide if he wants to draw or make a nose hit.
Yeah, we got an answer from Jerry. We'll have to go at the shooting percentage stats from slams. Could filter that out. I'm guessing it's very low, 5% or less. I think that we kind of agree.
I would agree with that, yeah.
Okay,
trois.
Not more than 5%, I would say.
Trois.
Not even less.
Deux. Minimum trois.
I think they have to switch this a little bit here.
Ouais, ouais, ouais. Faut y aller, faut y aller. Go, go, go. Toujours, toujours, toujours.
Spot.
Allez, allez. Go, go.
A little deeper would be nice.
You want to get it reasonably tight.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
If Ulstrud manages to get that double, I mean, I would probably bet the game is really in the pocket.
Yeah, I agree.
If he manages to get rid of those two red ones.
I got to keep them in the middle.
Even if he makes his peel. I think what Peter will try to do is just probably set one in the 8 foot and then he can decide if he has to draw the four or nose hit and then I guess you just let the curling gods take over.
Well, there's basically three possibilities. Either he misses the peel, less than 5% probably, and then Benoit draws behind the guard, forcing Ulstrud to a tough draw.
Whoa.
Either he makes the peel.
Unreal.
Ooh, so he probably makes the peel, sort of, kind of.
Probably doesn't change a whole bunch at the end of the day where this rock's going to go and then he'll have to play that draw. But
good thing is that yellow rock is only covering, let's say, I would think a third half of the 4 foot. So it leaves the whole of the 4 foot for him to draw. That's the good news.
Yep.
Bad news is that he could have had a much better situation, I was saying. Either he makes the peel but not the double, would have forced Benoit to play a rock in the top eight, leaving an open hit or an open draw for the win.
Yep. I think if I was Benoit, I'd leave this half in the 4 foot, leave it half buried, and maybe entice Thomas to go after it and tap it out, and who knows what happens, he might roll out and win, and you can get as most of the 4 foot as you can. Getting buried.
I think if he can be like right 100% behind that guard, half in the forefoot, that would be good shot. I think Ulstrud is probably already concentrating on his 4 foot draw.
I agree.
Yeah.
You can get it half, even if it's not quite buried, and you cut off a little more of his 4 foot, wouldn't be so bad.
Okay, T.
A little bit of excitement to finish the game here. Hopefully Benoit makes it good, and Ulstrud has to make a tough one.
So we're getting, that's what we call the money time.
Okay, Vince, c'est bon. Place.
Whoa. Well.
We were talking about the money time while there's big money actually in play because the winner of this game is going to leave Baden with 11,000 Swiss francs. And the second there will leave with 7,000 Swiss francs.
Pretty nice shot.
Oh, he got more or less. Oh, he got it good.
It's good. If he'd have got it another 6 inches, would be great. But
seems like Ulster not really thinking about the draw there. Anymore. He's just thinking about the halfway takeout.
Halfway tap for the win. And the first event on the curling champion tour. The Baden Masters.
And Mukis.
Max.
Maximum. Hackersen?
Little halfway tap for the win.
Oh, last rock of this game.
Patented shake.
Tutum, tutum.
Jakob!
Hard.
Rem.
Hard.
Last rock of the tournament.
Hard! Rem, rem,
yeah. Pretty pleased so far.
Yeah, rem. Hard rem.
Rem,
rem, rem. I think you're looking at your new champion of the Baden Masters 2014. Team Ulsrud. Well played game.
What a beautiful shot there. I think it was a bit more than half open. A
lot of picks.
But under the pressure, under the conditions, a really good achievement. And we can hear the crowd clapping. I think they're probably disappointed. They would have liked to see the home team from Switzerland win. But I think everybody's also proud of their tournament. I think they'll also be really happy. And I think that we have also a really good winner. Team Ulsrud has really performed really nicely. And I think they deserve that title.
I agree. They were probably the best all week, and they showed it here today, and it was a good game. It was a good show for us for the last couple hours here. Congratulations to Ulsrud, and well played by De Cruz.
All right. Well, I think that's it then.
Thank you for having me. It was a blast, Roger. We'll have to do it again sometime. And again, the Curling Champions Tour has done a great job, and Baden Masters, thank you for everything, and thanks for listening to me ramble for a couple hours here.
Well, you know, it was really a pleasure to welcome you in Switzerland. I mean, you're welcome whenever you want, and I mean, I invite all the people to come and visit this country, whether you like curling or not. I think people who listen there like curling, so basically, yeah. It's a nice place to come, so come back next year and don't play the final.
Well, we'll see what I can do about that. But no, thanks for having me, Roger, and take care.
So that was the Baden Masters. This is the first event of the Curling Champions Tour in this 2014-2015 season. And my name is Roger Gilka. I was commentating with Kirk Myers from Canada, Saskatoon, and have a good trip home. It was nice to see you, and thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. 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 Ye